My name is Emin Arif, the presenter of today's session, which is about plasmids. And I am here representing Synth Biotechnologist Association, SBA. Joshua Lederberg. The term plasmid was first introduced by the American molecular biologist Joshua Lederberg in 1952. He was an American molecular biologist known for his work in genetics, artificial intelligence, and space exploration. He won the 1958 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for discovering that bacteria can mate and exchange genes. He shared his prize with Edward Tatum and George Beadle, who won for their work with genetics. Now let's come upon the basic understanding of a plasmid. Plasmids are small double-stranded DNA molecules, usually circular, that can exist independently of host chromosomes and are present in many bacteria. They are also present in some yeasts and other fungi as well. They have their own replication origins, ORI regions, and are autonomously replicating and stably inherited, which means that they don't require anybody for its replication. Plasmids and bacterial chromosomes are separate replicons, which means that they have a specific sequence that has a replication origin and is capable of being replicated. Plasmids have relatively fewer genes, generally less than 30. They range in size from few hundreds to thousand genes, that is around 8 to 10 kilobase pairs. Their genetic information is not essential to the host and bacteria that let them usually function normally. If we talk about the structure of a plasmid, here you can see a plasmid map showing the three key parts of a plasmid. They have an origin of replication, a selectable marker gene, and a cloning site. The origin of replication is used to indicate where DNA replication is to begin. The selectable marker gene is used to distinguish cells containing the plasmids from the cells that don't contain it. The cloning site is a site in the plasmid where the DNA is inserted. They usually occur in bacteria such as E. coli and fungi or yeast such as Saccharomyces cerevisiae. PBR-322 is a type of plasmid. Here, the acronym PBR-32 stands for plasmid Bolivar and Rodriguez, whereas the 322 number indicates the number of variant of this plasmid DNA. This plasmid is 4,361 base pair long and consists of several restriction sites such as ECO-R1, HINT3, ECO-RV, BAM-HI, CELL-I, etc. These are the unique recognition sequences of this plasmid. It also contains two genes that confer resistance to different antibiotics such as tetracycline resistance and ampicillin resistance in PBR-322. Now let's discuss the types of plasmids. On the basis of function, plasmids are of the following type. Fertility plasmids, F plasmids, carry the fertility genes or TRA genes for conjugation, the transfer of genetic information between two cells. Resistance plasmid or R plasmids contains genes that can build resistance to antibiotics or poisons. However, the coalescence plasmid or COL plasmid contains genes that encodes for the antibacterial polypeptides called bacteriocins. a protein that kills other bacteria or strains of bacteria. The coli protein of E. coli are encoded by proteins such as coli E1. Other than that, degradative plasmids allow to digest unusual substances, whereas virulent plasmids turn bacterium into a pathogen. An episome is a plasmid of bacteria or viral DNA that can integrate itself into the chromosomal DNA of host organism. For this reason, it can stay intact for a long time, be duplicated with every cell division of the host, and become a basic part of its genetic makeup. By the ability to transfer genetic makeup to other bacterium, plasmids are of following types. Conjugative plasmids contain transgenes for non-sexual transfer of genetic material, which perform the complex process of conjugation, the transfer of plasmids to another medium, that is bacterium. Non-conjugative plasmids are incapable of initiating conjugation, hence they can only be transferred with the assistance of conjugative plasmids. Intermediate plasmids are mobilizable and carry only a subset of the genes required for the transfer. They can parasitize a conjugative plasmid, transferring at high frequency only in its presence. Plasmids are now being used to manipulate DNA and may possibly be a tool for curing many diseases. In this slide, you can see the mode of action of plasmids. Plasmid contains a gene for antibiotic resistance. This is a selectable marker in this plasmid, whereas it also contains several restriction sites such as ECOR1 in this plasmid. This restriction enzyme or site enables to cut the foreign DNA or the region of our interest, and then through DNA ligases, these sites are hybridized into the plasmids, and then they are called recombinant DNA. This recombinant DNA is inserted into a bacterial cell along with its bacterial chromosome, and then they are allowed to be cloned. After a few time, these clones may be plated on a bacterial medium with antibiotic. Only bacteria containing recombinant DNA will grow into a culture medium. These are then purified for getting the highest percentage of our concerned molecule. As I explained previously, the plasmid DNA is used in the gene therapy to transfer gene of interest in specific cell type. Therefore, there are many applications of plasmids. The first and foremost is the prevention of disease. Using gene therapy techniques, single gene disorders are now can be prevented. Therapeutic drugs and proteins are also produced by many plasmids and recombinant DNA technology, such as the production of insulin. Therapeutically important drugs and proteins are synthesized artificially outside the cell using the plasmid DNA. The recombinant DNA method is also used to transfer the gene for various purposes, such as for constructing the genetically modified organism or genetically modified products and other resistant species of plants. The plasmid DNA is also used in the gene knockout study and construction of knockout mice. Besides this, the plasmid DNA is also used in gene mapping and gene cloning as well. These are some outsources from which this whole presentation was created to make sure that you all maybe understand the basics of plasmids along with its application and its functions. I hope you all will now be able to understand that what plasmids are. Thank you for your time, and like I always said, that your support is always needed to make biotechnologists recognized not just in Sindh but in Pakistan. Till next time, take care. MNRF signing off. Allah Hafiz.